After you finish playing the game, you are gonna tell me what the game is about, okay? Please make sure you have the sound on. There's a button here in the right of your iPad. If you guys find the game a little difficult and you're finding some struggles with it, you can ask your neighbor. What is he doing? What is she doing in order to get through a level, okay? So feel free to do that. To talk to each other, ask questions. Ask questions to me and ask questions to your classmates. After they played the game for a bit, ask open-ended questions. What's the point of the game? What strategies did you use? Pause it and turn your iPad over. Okay, so do you guys like the game?
Yes.
Yes? Why? What is it about? Tell me, yes, Elias?
It's about you have to get these bottles of potions and you need to try to defeat your opponent.
You have to make it like if it says a 1 to 4, you can do a 2 to 8.
And then you have to try to use the color in the potions to make that ratio.
Okay, any other tricks or strategies that you found?
You can shuffle the board if you don't find a match.
Yeah, one strategy that I found is bigger ratios, because you can incorporate more things, like the lightning powers, to hit your opponent.
So what do we mean by bigger ratios? Just
instead of like just 1 to 1, make it towards like 5 to 5.
But how do you know that, for example, Moy was saying that 1 to 1 is the same as 5 to 5? How do you know that?
Basically, when you multiply the numerator, you have to multiply the denominator too.
To keep it equivalent. Okay, very good. Going through the levels, what kind of ratios were you asked to figure it out? Jacob?
It will ask you to do 3-part ratios.
3-part ratios, what's that?
Do you have to get all 3 of the numbers or to make the recipes?
Oh, good. Okay, so we're going to try to play some more, but this time I want you guys to help each other. Okay, so the people that has not gotten to the other levels, help the others and share your strategies, okay? And also, remember to use what we were discussing earlier about the equivalent ratios.
Ask different questions about the math, about the game, then get them right back into playing again so they can apply what they've learned.
So can you tell me an equivalent ratio to that one, to 2 to 2?
While the students are playing the game, it's important to walk around, ask questions. This gives you the chance to see how they're doing, what they're struggling with. It also models the importance of discussing the game with each other and sharing strategies.
I saw that most of you were getting to the 3-part ratios, right? Were there any other kind of ratios? Jacob?
There was decimal ratios.
Decimal ratios. Decimals, like what?
Instead of holes, it started going into halves.
Okay, and how do you deal with those? Can you come up here and show us?
Yes.
Which level?
I'm on level 13.
Level 13, okay.
The students really struggle with equivalent ratios. Take advantage of the game and the discussion to really help them to get this concept. Having the game up on the screen in front of the class, it's really helpful for the discussion.
Okay, so you're changing a 1 to 1.5 to a 2 to 3 ratio. Is that an equivalent ratio? Yes? Okay, let's see. Oh yeah, it was. Yeah, very good.
Depending on your schedule, you might have the students play the game 1 day, 3 days, several periods. Encourage them to play it at home as well.
That would be it for today. And as I promised, I'm going to give you the cheats for the game so you can go home and play, okay? So if you are in your computer, the cheat would be Shift-C. And if you're playing in an iPad, you're just going to tap 5 times on the logo, on the Racial Rumble logo.
I like to spend 1 day playing and discussing the game, and another day doing some hands-on activities, maybe with manipulatives.
Okay, now what are we going to do with those cubes you have and the list of ratios I just gave you, okay? We're going to try to build those 3 ratios that you see, but I want you guys to use the strategies that you use in the game. How do we get equivalent ratios? How do we get bigger ratios? How do we do that?
By multiplying them,
okay. So we can do that for those ratios as well, okay?
I have students build 2- and 3-part ratios with integers and decimals. Then I have them explain what they've done.
This one is × 5, because we already did double, then triple, then 100.
Oh.
So
Oh, so this is one ratio, the whole thing. This is one ratio.
How does this activity relate to Racial Rumble? Jacob.
You can do it by using 3D objects, and you don't just have to use potions to do it. You can use anything.
Very good. Bella, can you come up here and explain me how you did your ratios, how your team work out the ratios you were given? Okay. And you guys can help her, okay? 1.5. Now, can you get the rest of it, Bella? What would be the second one? 3, right? Very good. Okay, now, looking at this information we have here about ratios, what do you guys think would be a nice way to arrange this information, to put this information? What would it be? Jacob?
Like in a table?
In a table, okay. So let's put that one in a table.
5 to 15.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Jacob.
With all our math snacks, it's always good to end with math vocabulary. Sometimes it prompts even more questions.
Now, can you tell me some of the math words that you guys have learned after all these activities? Oh, wow, I see. Okay, so I'll start this time by Crystal.
Equivalent.
Ratios.
Decimal.
Multiply.
I have a question.
Yes.
Can you also divide the numbers?
Yes, what do you guys think?
Yes?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so how would that work? So we can divide both by 2? And what would we get?
1 to 2.
Okay, in the game. Now thinking about the game, is it helpful to make equivalent ratios that are smaller?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Smaller? Sometimes? Yes? Uh-huh. When exactly?
Just whenever you're stuck and you can't find like 1 red and 2 greens, and you can only find like half of a red and 1 green.
Oh, very good. Yeah, so you can use it as a strategy when you're stuck, right? So you can build smaller ratios by dividing, okay? Okay, just to wrap up, guys. What do we do to build equivalent ratios? We can do what?
Multiplying.
Dividing. Or dividing. Very good. Okay, another question for you. How would these activities help you get better at Racial Rumble or get to higher levels? Do you think it'll help? How? Why? Moi, this time.
It works on our multiplying skills.
Multiplying skills, yes. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to get back to the game and see if we get to higher levels having learned all this, okay?
Yay!
The students have fun with this game. But not only that, they're developing their understanding of this hard concept of ratio. And that's what we want.